your life.
Jesus is the slave master.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 17. Think not that I have come to destroy the law or the prophets.
But to fulfill.
I have come to destroy, but to fulfill.
What is Christ fulfilled?
Jesus has fulfilled nothing.
Faith, Yehoshua is the Messiah.
Jesus is the slave master, God. Jesus was invented 400 years ago.
That's my brother. That's my brother. It's not disrespect. He came to unite. Did he not come to unite the children and then go back?
You have another word of this?
First Corinthians 14:40. Let all things be done decently.
Jesus is the judge.
You heard what the scripture said? Let everything be due discipline and order. What that mean? What that mean?
Exactly what he said. Jesus,
but you're not doing it because you're not keeping God's commandment, brother.
What commandment is he not keeping?
We just bring a law to you. The laws are big. You don't keep it. Look at your fridges.
Yes.
Bug out your mind.
Number 1538. Yeah,
what that
look
mean?
Look at my fridges.
What that mean?
Blue street.
What that mean?
That means
what
I'm keeping the law.
Brother, your face all
that's
shaved off. Why the hell you keep a law?
My beard?
Come on,
what, because my beard's not grown?
Isaiah 29.
Because my beard's not fully grown out?
Give me that Isaiah 29.
Because my beard's not fully grown out?
This is what you fit right here.
But you believe in Jesus. That's the slave master's God.
Messiah, man.
Jesus is the slave Christ. That's Greek. The son of Zeus.
Chapter 29 and verse 13. Therefore, the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me, with their mouth.
You're just a mouth speaker, man. You're not about God's
Jesus
mouth.
Was invented 400 years ago.
You
look
at honor
the
me.
Of
you see, with your lips, you'll claim you honor the law, but
the
you don't follow law one. We.
Jesus what is the slave master's God. That's the Gentile.
Your mind moving away from the Lord, brother. You follow
Jesus.
The so-called white Jews, man. You think it's something
Jews
in the white people.
We're Israelites. It's
you think so? You understand what I'm saying to you? Will you follow the white Jews philosophy? Look at you. You're trying to come to a man who will learn. You're a foolish man.
Jesus is a white Gentile. His name means Hail Zeus,
brother,
son of
how
Zeus.
Would you know God's name
Jesus
when you're not keeping no commandment?
By
how would
Gentile.
You know God's name if you're not keeping
Jesus
no commandment?
Is created
come on,
by the Gentile.
You with your own mouth saying that. Christ got all that commandment.
Council of Nicaea. Look it up.
Isaiah.
That's what it created Jesus. That's what it created Jesus.
Isaiah 29.
That's
and
what it created Jesus.
13.
And
wherefore the Lord
Israel
said, for as much as the people join near me with their mouths.
You see, you don't even scriptures. You see how disrespectful you are? That brother is reading God's word. If you're about God, you're going to be
God
quiet. Shut the hell up, brother.
God.
Let the scripture come out.
God is
read.
Word
for Zeus.
Read. Join near me with their mouth and their lips. You are the beast. What's
the word?
Every Jew had a heart.
You got demon on you.
I got a demon
on.
They said that about the Messiah.
You got demon.
They said that about the Messiah.
But you know the Messiah keep God's laws, though.
God,
but you don't keep God's
God
laws. The Messiah keep the laws, though, right? But you don't.
God.
So you're not the Messiah. You fall away from knowing the Messiah.
God
read the scripture.
The word for
Matthew.
Yo, logic. I'm like,
Matthew chapter 5 and verse. In verse 17, think not that I come to destroy the law or the prophet.
I say he did not come to destroy the law, which the brother is a liar. Because Christ got away with that law. You're a liar, man. You're a liar. You're a liar. Let the scripture speak for itself.
I have not come to destroy, but
the council of Nicaea. The council of Nicaea. Jesus was created 400 years ago. There is no letter J until 1633. In English, all facts that you can look up. All facts.
All facts. I can be a lesbian. I can be whatever they want, right?
All facts.
Uh-huh. But you don't even obey the son. Why would you obey the father? You don't obey the son.
They talk about Jesus.
Come on, man.
Jesus is fake.
For you to know the father, you have to know the son. For you to know the son, you have to know the father. But right now, we've been in laws to you and keep him, brother. The laws are big. What happened to it? Those are simple things. Which is in your clothes. Those are simple things.
And these are simple things, but they don't mean that you're going to the lake of fire.
Matthew.
Just because you're being
you see that? He said that those are simple things, but they don't mean you're going to be destroyed.
Check this out.
You're a foolish man.
Oh, yeah?
He listen to yourself.
Check this out. Check this out.
No, you're more older than you. Listen to yourself.
Check this out.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 18. First, Matthew 5, 19. Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments.
But your man said he can break it.
No, I'm saying that Jesus teaches all followers to break the law. That's why you have homos. That's why you eat pork. That's why you have all these things that happen today. Because you follow Jesus. That's what Jesus teaches.
This is your Jesus. This is your Jesus. That teach you don't give no laws. I guess you know about laws.
Jesus was created 400 years ago in the Council of Nicaea. There is no letter J in English until 1633. Yehoshua is HaMashiach. Jesus is the Gentile. His name does have no Hebrew meaning. He's a fact.
What do you teach?
Are you done?
Okay, you done? Sing it three times. Four times.
Jesus has our people stupid.
Five times.
That's created by our enemies.
Six times.
Our people stay with you.
You're beating yourself. You done?
So are you.
Are you done? So are you. So are you. So can I talk now? Can I talk?
Go ahead. You speaking wisdom? Okay. Are you speaking Jesus? Because wisdom is the law. Jesus didn't teach the law. Okay. Jesus taught the law was finished. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. All you think that all Christians believe
how
Jesus taught the law.
Jesus
is fake.
Jesus is not Jesus.
It's fake.
Luke is not
pronounced
Christian. It's pronounced fake.
Right.
Not pronounced Zeus, dumbass. Right. In the Greek language, letter Z is pronounced the D. You dumb. It's D-O, but you simple as hell.
There's
no reason. Right. Right.
No, I'm not emotional.
Zeus is not D. And you cut right there already.
Yeah, but check this out.
No, no, no. Check that thing out. Zeus is, you know what I'm saying?
See how stupid
she is. Zeus is pronounced Deus in Greek. It's not Zeus. Jesus.
Jesus. Deus. It's still all the Gentiles. Our people love
you. You took that back.
You love to follow the Gentiles.
That's wrong.
They love to follow
the book, verse 17, chapter 6, verse 3.
Shut up, bro.
You're
a
whore with Jesus.
If any man teach otherwise, and consent not to wholesome word, if any man teach otherwise, and consent not to wholesome word, not to wholesome word, even the words of our Lord Jesus Christ into the doctrine which is according to godliness. He is proud.
He is what?
He is proud.
You want to stop talking? He is proud. Go ahead.
Knowing nothing.
You know, he don't teach the people at all. Remember the name for himself, up front of us.
I teach everywhere. No, you don't. You a damn cowardly nigga. Perverse disputing of men.
What I have?
Reverse.
No, I thought it said.
Perverse!
Perverse, go ahead!
Disputings of men!
Perverse disputings of men is such a word! Go ahead!
Of corrupt mind!
Of what?
Of corrupt mind!
Wearing Jewish scriptures! That's corrupt mind! Israel did not wear business like that. They didn't wear Jewish strings.
Right!
They wore all around the garments!
Right.
All around the garments! The border, all around! All four quarters, things around, all around the earth!
Read! With that wave pattern.
Go ahead!
And destitute of the truth!
And what?
And destitute of the truth.
Don't teach no more.
Isaiah 28 and verse 11. For a stammering lip in another tongue will he speak to this people.
What?
With stammering lips in another tongue.
Another language, go ahead.
Will he speak to this people?
So in English, Jesus is in fact Yahshua, as he said, which goes back to English, Jesus. English is Jesus, and in Hebrew is Yahshua, or in Greek is Yeshu. Yeshu. Not Yesus, or Yesus, that's retarded. The letter S at the end of Jesus is silent.
Right.
Only when it's an action verb, it's an action word. Like when he does something, it's added at the S at the end.
Right.
It's not Iesus, it's Iesu. You know a damn thing.
Bring
scholar. Iesu is in Greek. Iesu is in Latin.
Right.
When the subject to the verb, it's Iesus at the end. It's not Iesus. Zeus is pronounced Dio, Deus, or Dios. That doesn't even spell the same way in Greek. Iesu is Iesu. Or Jesus, Jesus Cristo, in Spanish. Dios, as in daytime, he was a day god. He was Dios, and Dios is a female, or Deus. That has nothing to do with Jesus,
right,
at all. That's complete semantics, you know a damn thing. That's why he walked off, because Deus and Zeus are the same thing.
Right.
Letter C in Greek is pronounced as a D, Deus. It's not Jesus, or son of Zeus. That's Google doctrine. That's the Google scholar. You know a damn thing, man. Read on.
For we're stabbing lips in another tongue will he speak to this people.
You niggas in this lame stuff don't keep no laws. I'm telling you, I'm tired of y'all, this lame stuff.
You got tattoos.
You got tattoos, it's being shaped up, but the name, y'all talking about Jehovah's Witnesses say the same thing.
Boy,
you must say Jehovah God.
Huh?
You must say it.
Huh?
But they don't keep no damn laws, man.
Right, right, right.
All these name-alikes don't keep no laws.
Right.
Don't teach no laws.
Right.
I need to name the name. Then they go, oh, mother, say my faith. But say my faith. But they commit all the sins of under the damn sun. Lying their brother, adulterers, murderers in their heart, slanderers. But the name, brother, the name. Give me Psalm 46 and smash this thing. Call it Jesus' name. Matthew 1:21. Get you read this. Annihilate this dude. Sirach, chapter
46
and 1.
Matthew 1:21.
Watch, let's see what Jesus' name is in Greek.
Sirach, chapter 46 and verse 1.
Man, hold that thing. Get that first. Watch this. Because our people on the Bible in the English, done in Israel, now Hebrew's a factor. Was Hebrew a factor with Moses? Can he speak Hebrew well? Nope. He said, use Aaron. Moses said, I can't speak Hebrew well. He said, well, use Aaron then. He didn't say, I'm going to teach Hebrew, Moses. I'm teaching Hebrew now. That ain't biblical. What about Acts 2? They spoke bastard languages. They learned Hebrew in Acts 2. They had the word of God in their tongues. Idiots. Read that.
Sirach 46 and 1.
Oh, wait. Let's do Hebrew for a second. Hebrew. Is Hebrew an Israelite language or is it a universal language? Originally. What language did all nations speak before? Hebrew. What language did Esau speak? Hebrew. What language did Israel speak? Hebrew. What language did Bob and Aram and the Midian speak? Hebrew. Are they Israelites too? Hebrew was never a factor. The word of God was the factor. Read that.
And the law, it is written.
Well,
and the law, it is written.
Where?
And the law, it is written.
Read.
With men of other tongues.
With what?
With men of other tongues.
With men of heathen languages.
And other lips.
And other languages.
Will I speak unto this people?
Will he what?
Will I speak unto this people?
Will he speak for the language, for example, Spanish? And French, how you got in French?
Yeah.
How you feel in French?
Yeah.
That sound like God to you?
With a what?
With a D. That's not in French to you? Does Jazz sound like God to you in French? No. That show, you said God in French over there. Who that? Jazz? Oh, okay, I understand. Read that again.
And the law that is written with men of other tongues and other lips
speaks.
Will I speak unto this people?
French, English, Spanish, go ahead.
And yet, for all that,
and yet, for all that, even in the English language, go ahead.
Will they not hear me?
Even in the Hebrew, English, they still don't listen. They ain't listening to in Hebrew, they listen to in English. They're rebellious across the board. Read.
And yet, for all that, will they not hear me? Saith the Lord.
Sirach 46 and 1. Jesus. The son of Naive was valiant in the wars. He was the successor of Moses. Jesus, the son of Naive, was valiant in the wars.
Jesus, the son of Naive, read ahead.
And was the successor of Moses.
They're not the Moses, go ahead.
In prophecies.
And what?
In prophecies.
Go ahead.
Who according to his name.
Well, stop. According to his what?
According to his name.
According to his name in Greek, Yesu, or in English, Jesus, go ahead.
Was made great for the saving of the elect of God.
Made great for the what?
For the saving of the elect of God.
That's what Jesus means in Greek. He saves. Read that, please.
Matthew chapter 1, verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus.
In Greek, go ahead.
For he shall save his people.
What?
He shall save his people from their sins.
That's what Jesus means, or Jesus means, or Jesus means. He saves. In Greek. Verse 23.
Behold, a virgin shall be with child.
Go ahead.
And shall bring forth a son. And they shall call his name Emmanuel.
Oh, name what?
Emmanuel.
No, Yahshua.
Emmanuel.
Another name. So which one is it? And that's another name. Read on.
Which being interpreted.
With what?
Which being interpreted.
So which other name? Emmanuel. Interpreted as what?
As God with us.
As what?
God.
God does. So the chain, the man is long, then he's jumping it, which means the guy with a big jump, 4:25.
The book of John, chapter 4, verse 25.
The Bible translates itself. We don't need your help.
The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah has coming. I know that Messiah is coming, which is called Christ. When he is come, he will tell us all things.
Hear it again.
The woman saith unto him, I know that Messiah is coming.
I know the Messiah is coming. Go ahead.
Which is called Christ.
Which is called what?
Christ.
What Messiah mean?
Christ.
Anointed. This 141.
John chapter 1 verse 41. He first blinded his own brother Simon and saith unto him, we have found the Messiah.
We have found what?
We have found the Messiah.
So we found the Messiah. Messiah is weak. Messiah.
What is being interpreted?
What is being interpreted? Like Emmanuel interpreted God with us. Go ahead.
The Christ.
Stop. Read it again.
He first finding his own brother Simon and saith unto him, we have found the Messiah.
We found the Messiah, go ahead.
Which is being interpreted.
Which being interpreted is what? No, go ahead.
The Christ.
No, the Zeus.
The Christ.
No, Messiah means the Zeus in Greek.
The Christ.
Oh, okay. Give me that verse.
And brought him to Jesus. And when Jesus beheld him, saying, thou art Simon, the son of Jonah, thou shalt be called Cephas.
That's what he called what?
Cephas.
Cephas, go ahead.
Which is interpreted
what?
By interpretation, a stone.
What?
A stone.
Cephas means so the Bible translates itself. So it says interpreted to Christ, that's what Messiah means. That means Zeus. And Cephas interpreted means the stone. Jump up the ball, beat up. Verse 38.
Verse 38. Then Jesus turned and saw them following and said unto them, what seek ye? They said unto him, Rabbi, which is to say, being interpreted, Master.
Then what? Rabbi was interpreted what?
Master.
Rabbi is interpreted means master. Or sir. That's what Rabbi means in English. To mean master or sir. The Bible translates itself. So Christ in the Bible means anointing or Messiah. It don't mean no damn son of Zeus. It don't mean no damn son of Zeus. They're making things up. You're going to start the Bible. The Bible 30 verse 6, please. Give me the book. Get some more interpretations of God.
Book of Proverbs, chapter 30 and verse 6.
Watch this.
Mark chapter 15 and verse 34.
So all that talk he did said that Zeus is Jesus. Now it's completely wrong and false. Now you're over there cowering the corner. Because he was off. He said facts. Zeus was never called Zeus in Greek. It was Deus. We'll say it again. It was called Deus or Dios, idiot. Stop it, you don't study for yourself. Copy what Google brought to you.
Right.
Just read that, please.
And at the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eloi, 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 Eloi,
Eli, Eli.
Lama sabachthana, which is being interpreted,
what?
Being interpreted, my God, why hast thou forsaken
me? Eli means my God, Lama sabachthana means hast thou forsaken me. You know, the Bible explains itself. The Bible explains what it's saying. They spoke in Hebrew, the Bible explains what they were saying. Read it again.
And at the next hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice saying, Eli, Lama sabachthani, which is being
translated or explained,
my God,
Eli,
why hast thou forsaken me?
Lama sabachthani. The Bible explains what he's saying. Read that, please.
John chapter 19 and verse 19.
The argument was, why don't we say that? I'm sure. Why don't we say that? Let's say it. Watch this. We say whatever edifies the people. People don't know who Yahweh Shai is out here. They don't know who Yahushua is. They don't know who Jesus is. But we're going to speak in order to the edification of the people. We also say Yahweh Shai. We'll say it out of respect for you. or your Astro out of respect. Don't come over here trying to bombard us with your nonsense. You will get embarrassed out here. Especially with that Zeus stuff. You got destroyed with that. That was horrible. That was a horrible attempt. Read on. With a damn wave cap on. Read that.
John 1919 in Pilate wrote a title and put it on the cross.
John the Pilate, a Roman, put the Messiah's name on the cross. Go ahead.
And the writing was Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews.
Watch this. The writing is the writing in English. Jesus of Nazareth in English, King of the Jews. Now watch this, please.
This title did read many of the Jews.
This title read many of the Jews. Go ahead.
For the place where Jesus was crucified was nigh to the city.
He was there where all the Jews were, for they all came to see his body. They were reading what it said on the cross. On the engraving on the cross. Watch.
And it was written in Hebrew.
Stop. So the Jews read it in what language?
In Hebrew.
They read it Yahashua or Yahawashua. They read that. Or Yahshua. They read that. Go ahead.
In Greek.
They read it in what language they read it in?
In Greek and Latin.
So it was written in Latin and Greek. So it was spoken in Latin and Greek.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.